Damn it, I'm sorry. Yes, that'll be great. Thank you. Thank you.
Is that a tour going on?
Sure, something.
Okay.
Oh, wow. That is really tiny.
I have a water.
Oh, this is great. Thank you. The worst night. The most non-stop, meaningful silence. Don't get married, that's my advice.
I'm already married.
That's right. Hope you brought a good book.
So, I didn't realize that you're, so you're married?
I was. I remember laying in bed listening to the breathing. it's sad, you know. Sit there, you read beside the cereal box, you know, half your plates are gone, half your cups, and more pretty shoes by the front door. And that's your little half-life. How about you? Are you getting settled?
I am. We are. More and more. This is all just a big change, you know?
Yeah. I'm sorry, what is?
Here. And the whole idea of having children.
Oh, God, yeah, I have two nieces.
Oh, that's great. Girls.
Yeah, it is great. You know what? I think it's actually just the one niece. I think the other one is a friend. I don't know. Not a very good uncle. Still go for a nephew, though. That I have time.
Zing! You said that the day we met.
Yeah, something like it. I'm sure it's a theory of mine.
It's not really a theory. You're just kind of making different sounds with your mouth.
So are you.
True. So, how's gravity?
Fine, I think. What the so what?
You were reading a book about gravity?
Oh, yeah. No. No. I'm done with that. I'm sorry. I just wanted you to know about that. All right. No. I've moved on. I'm taking a course on watercolor painting.
Wow. You're quite a renaissance man.
You know, it's actually not really a course, it's just the instructions that came with the paints.
Well, it still sounds great.
It's not. You know, it's just another thing.
You know, I think you'd make a really great uncle.
You know, I would too, but I'm not. I panic. You know, I get panicky, right? Hey, what's a panicky uncle? I get nervous, you know.
I feel that way sometimes.
Yeah, me too.
Anyway, Bob is finishing up some things at his job in our old house. He just got a new position. He should be here soon. I still don't really know the area in here. It can get kind of lonely.
Yeah, so you go out and check the mail. Oh, it's a catalog! You know, you leaf through it and, oh, it's a pair of pants. I can buy those pants. Then you think, you know what, then it would just be me in another pair of pants. And then, go out and you take a walk, and that's pretty much your day. Time for bed.
Wow, that is kind of gloomy. I like looking through catalogs. Anyway, it's not so bad. I get to see Bob here and there at a convention or something else nearby. He's in sales.
I always wanted to be in something.
Really? Well, I'm sure you, if you want, you know.
Thanks, that's nice. Thank you.
Sorry. I haven't been sleeping very well.
Duh, nighttime. And daytime, too. It's like, enough, I get it already. As I was reading this article on identity theft the other day, I actually got a little jealous. I was like, go and just take it already. You know, good luck, fella. Sometimes I think I should just go slip into the bathroom with an X-Acto knife and quietly retire, but I start some dumb project or start reading something about some idiot thing.
John?
You have a really nice voice.
Mary.
Mary. I like it.
You know, we all have our dark nights. We're probably not as alone as we think.
Yeah, no. We hope. And I'm sorry you can't sleep. I'm sorry it probably seemed like I didn't hear you, but I did.
Mm-hmm. Well, I wish I could sleep. But I appreciate it. I'm sure you're just making different sounds with your mouth again, but I really appreciate it.
I'm sorry. I didn't ask you much about it yourself.
Is that, are you asking me now?
I don't know, I guess so, yes. I don't know, I just, You know, sometimes you forget the meaning for the words for things, but then you suddenly remember the thing. Well, I don't know, I suddenly pictured you with the real Mary, not sleeping, or reading a book, or crying, or doing whatever it is that you do.
I do read, sometimes. Yeah, sometimes cry, too. You know, it's really nice that you picture me in tears, or reading. The nights are hard, you know. They get quiet. I never really know what I'm supposed to be listening to. But it does give me time to catch up on my needless worry.
I do that. What you just did.
What?
Hey, you know, you use humor to distance yourself from the pain.
I was using humor to try to be funny.
That is something different. listen, if you're needing help, think of a needless word.
Well, last night I couldn't stop thinking, what if my taste buds just stopped working?
Massive heart failure in a public place.
Oh, you can do better than that. That's kind of a guy thing anyway.
Cancer in the privacy of your own home?
The old standby, but yes, good. Something for the ladies.
It's good to laugh. And I like what you said, you know, dark nights.
Well, I guess all nights are dark, but you know what I mean. Oh, before I forget, I was wondering, could you come over and take a look at...
Yeah, no, I'd love to.
it's a plumbing thing. I think it's just a quandary.
Hoping it was a painting or a sunset, but yeah, sure, I'd be happy to. I can use the work. Not that I would charge you, but... speaking of not making any money, I should get going. what day is it?
Tuesday.
Shit. I thought it was Monday.
Sorry.
That's alright, I'll find out eventually.
I'll give you a calm jump.
Alright, nice seeing you again.
Oh, it was. It was very nice. If we could hear... if you... Wonderful. Bye, John.
Bye.
Hi, everybody. This book just came back, and we're going to be reading this together. It's called American Indians, the First Nations. Life had gone on. Several moons had passed, several months. The medicine man shook his feathers. The medicine man is a doctor. A star shone over Input Way. That's here. Well, it was. The medicine man spoke in difficult ways of difficult things in the worried vocabulary of medicine and night. The villagers listened quietly and quietly misunderstood. The sick man listened and quietly got worse. For sick man, think of anybody, an average person. A little child has written in the margin here, anxiety, sickness, death, spiritual. She writes in these wonderful loopy letters in a bright red pen. At least I think it's a girl. The medicine man continued differently now. His calm eyes sparkled as he turned to the blushing woman there. And for blushing woman, he's probably thinking of a bride or a woman falling in love. He spoke in simple ways of simple things. He asked the moon to be beautiful. He asked the sun to come to warm the unborn child and the born mother. He asked the people to be human and the animals to stay animals. He asked the universe to expand. He said deeply to all of them, great things, oh, great things. Someone is born, someone will die. Both are you, unwind, unknown. The same little girl has written a question mark here. I read once that the question mark came from Gregorian chant. It was used to show that a phrase would have an upward intonation, that it would rise upward to heaven. Imagine this little red one here. No sentence, no question. Just this little red question mark rising up to heaven, rising up to God. Can you imagine the look on his face? A few pages later, she's written the word atmosphere. And here is a barrette she used as a bookmark. Ah, literature. It's a beautiful night, whether or not there's anything up there.
Cora 9, this is Ground Control, Houston. Do you read? Do you copy?
Copy. This is C9. Sounds like you're right in my living room. Over.
The things we can do. Go ahead, C9. How's life?
Well, this view, for one thing. I heard about it, but wow, it's wonderful. I never knew how round was, Houston. God. And all this space is just pure majesty, just endless, majestic. But it's cold, it's almost raw data, raw mathematics. And then you see little planet Earth. Oh, it's so welcoming and good. Seems like a symphony should be playing somewhere. It's just this fragile, beautiful little thing, like something a happy child would draw. It's so blue, Houston.
Sorry,
repeat please.
51 degrees, angle, sensor arm, 2 minutes 45.
Copy. Arm is in position. Up.
What's that? Didn't catch that.
Sorry.
Go ahead, Greg.
Just thinking about life back home. There was this guy once thought he had found a meteorite. Turned out to be plain sedimentary rock just made out of dead animals and dead plants crushed together. And he was disappointed. It shouldn't have been, though. I really wasn't crazy about him. I think he bashed my mailbox in. Anyway, man, he shouldn't have been sad. That rock he found, the field he found it in, all these things are miraculous because all these things are earthly.